I'm getting ready to start my early season seeds, and I thought I'd do a little experiment this year. So I got 4 different seed starting kits from different places, and I'm going to see if it makes any difference as far as germination or seedling vigor, health, or anything like that. This is the Jiffy Seed Starter Greenhouse. I'm just gonna slide that off of there. And you can see it's got these little peat cells. And underneath here, we've got some plant food and some little plant labels. I'm just gonna set those in there. It's also got a humidity dome down here. I'm gonna use my organic seed starting mix and just fill all of these trays up. And then I'm just gonna moisten the seed starting media. Ideally, I would just take this outside and use the soaker hose, but it's really cold outside right now, so I'm not going to. One thing I really do not like about some of these seed starting mixes that you buy, in particular at the big box stores, they've sat around so long that they can actually become like hydrophobic and they just don't even wanna soak up that water. I let this Jiffy kit sit and soak for a while, and I sprayed the top again with my sprayer for my sink, and we're finally starting to get a little moisture in there. I'm gonna go ahead and plant these. Just make a little planting divot in each cell. Put the humidity dome on. The next kit is the Burpee self-watering system. We've got some illustrated instructions. So our first step is to remove all the parts from the watering tray. So we got that. This is our wicking system. And then we've got some plant tags in here and a germination sheet that is, I don't know what's going on here. I don't think it's supposed to rip like that. And we have a Burpee plantogram where I can write down everything that I've planted. So it says we want to place all the pellets flat side down. So you can see they're kind of flipped around in there, some of them. So we're just gonna make sure that they're all flat. You can see, like, just to give you a better example, that's what the pellet looks like, and we're getting them all so they're sitting like that. The next step is to add warm water very slowly and evenly to the pellets as needed. Add the warm water to each of these little pellets. So if you can see in here, these little pellets, they've soaked up, I think, most of the water that they're gonna soak up. And then the instructions say just to break up the soil, which you can see they're still pretty solid. So I would just need to break these all up. But this part is a rather giant pain in the tuchus, quite honestly. So I'm getting very frustrated. I've been trying to break these little pellets apart for, I mean, I think it's been like 5 minutes, but it feels like a really long time. I've used a similar kit to this before, and I don't recall having quite this much trouble getting these broken apart. I don't know if this one just maybe sat around too long or what the issue is, but this is not incredibly user-friendly. So once we got all these cells filled up, I had to remove some of the excess water from the bottom. The next part is actually take these out and place the trays, or the stands rather, in here, and then place fully moistened self-watering mat black side up on raised supports. So this is not fully moistened yet, but I will get some water over here and do that. And then I'm going to set those back on top, and then we can plant our seeds. Okay, and then the last step is to put this germination mat, which basically works, I'm guessing, in the same way that like putting plastic wrap over your seedlings would. I think this is supposed to be all one nice sheet. I'm not sure why mine is shredding apart like this. It is compostable, which I appreciate, which is also probably why it's falling apart. But you just cover it up. I'm gonna put that on my seed starting rack and fill up that reservoir with water, but that sheet that we laid down is supposed to wick water up to the bottom of those trays, and then the soil wicks it up to the seedlings. The next kit some gurneys. And this one has a humidity dome. And like I said, you just pop these grow plugs into the styrofoam tray. They already have a pretty good amount of moisture in them. But once I get everything seeded, I'm going to fill up this bottom reservoir with water. And the plugs will soak that up to the seedlings as needed. And then they've already got pre-dibbled planting holes, so I'm just gonna pop the seeds right into those holes. We're just gonna fill up that bottom reservoir with water, and we put the humidity dome on, and we're done. And the final kit is from Parks. It's very similar to the way the Gurney's one was set up. So a reservoir tray with a styrofoam tray, and these little grow plugs pop right in there. And we'll just go ahead and seed these as well. Hey, those guys are a little smaller, so I have to be a little more precise in how I'm seeding these. So we put the lid on, and this is vented. So right now, until these germinate, I want to keep this on and keep humidity high. Once they're up, I can vent it and eventually take it off. So now we've got all four kits here planted and the humidity domes are put on. The one from Park Seed, the one from Burpee, the one from Gurney's, and this is the one from Menards, the Jiffy kit.
Make sure to check back because I'll be giving updates on how all of the seeds are germinating and how the seedlings are going as the season progresses.